What is up everybody, I'm Ritwik Dashora and I'm back with a video and some new learnings. In this video, I'm going to tell you how to synchronize Bloomberg directly with Python. For everyone who has some exposure to Bloomberg and extracting the data from Bloomberg, everyone uses Excel in order to extract the financial information from Bloomberg. And we use formulas like BDH, BDP, BDS. These are the Excel formulas that are used to extract the financial information. In this video, I'm going to tell you how to directly synchronize Bloomberg with Python such that you don't need Excel. It will automatically take data from Bloomberg and then you can use it. Before starting this thing, I would like to tell you that for this thing to work, you should have a valid subscription with Bloomberg, otherwise it won't work. So as you can see, I have the valid subscription of Bloomberg in my laptop, so I can use it. If you don't have it, you can do it in your corporate office laptop, in which you are provided with the Bloomberg subscription. Or if you are the college student, definitely there would be some Bloomberg terminals, and on that Bloomberg terminal you can do this thing. Before starting this video, I would like to congratulate each and everyone who are a part of Financial Programming with Ritwik community, because we have just crossed the milestone of 200 subscribers, and it is, I would say, way faster than I was expecting, because I know that this field is very niche and there are very few people who are interested in financial programming, but I'm getting a very good response. And also I'm trying to give it back as much as possible by sharing my personal Google Drive and sharing all the codes that I make for my personal use. It's free for everyone. For my new viewers who has no idea about what I'm talking about, you can actually go to my YouTube channel. This is my YouTube channel, and there's a feature on my YouTube channel of this access to my Google Drive. You can click on this button and just fill some information like your name and email address, which I will be using to give access of my personal Google Drive. And I save all my codes over there. You can download them for your personal uses. But the only condition that is required is that please subscribe to my YouTube channel before doing that. I would validate it before giving the access. Let's start with this video. So, actually, we have to follow some steps in order to synchronize Bloomberg with Python. I tried looking for this information on internet and I would say in YouTube also, and there is very limited information available of how to synchronize Bloomberg with Python. That's why I struggled a lot, and then I have come to this some steps that I made myself. And we just need to follow this. I want to share all this with you such that you don't struggle like me. So what you need to do here is you just install this. I'll put it in the description box such that you can copy and paste. So you just need to install pip install this and pip install XGBB. XGBB is the library that is used to connect with the Bloomberg API, and through this we can actually use formulas like BDH, BDP that we use in Excel. I'll tell you how to how does this XGBB works. Then what you need to do here is actually if you go to this XGBB, you just need to do pip install XGBB, and I went through the requirements. If you click on this one, this Bloomberg API library, it will open this thing. And actually it's pretty clearly mentioned here. So what you need to do here is you need to install C++ experimental release. What does it mean? It means that there's no direct Python library for this thing, for the API connection. And there's a C++ experimental release for that. So you need to download this one by clicking here. And then it will be a zip file. Extract that zip file. There will be a lot of files, and then copy these two particular DLL files and then paste it to the Anaconda installation files. That's it. This is what you need to do. Actually, it's mentioned here under bin folder of the Bloomberg API root folder. Actually, there is no folder like Bloomberg API root folder. That's why I was struggling a lot. What I did was I just pasted these two files on the installation, all installation files of Anaconda. And then what you need to do is you need to have a very good internet connection, right? Let me see if I have covered it. Yeah, then install, exactly. So this is a very important thing. You need to install Bloomberg software, which is this one. Of course, like you would be thinking that of course we need to install this one. No, this is not so obvious because there are many people who use Bloomberg through Citrix receiver. It won't work if you use if you're using Citrix receiver. You'll have to install the application. For this, you may need to call the Bloomberg team as well for the login, because I had to do it, and then synchronize your mobile, like phone number, and for all the times you would say you log in, you need to enter an OTP that comes to your personal phone number. For this, you need to take some help from Bloomberg team. So install the Bloomberg software, and then maybe call the Bloomberg team for assistance of how to start the Bloomberg terminal in the laptop, not the Citrix one, the Bloomberg terminal, the actual software, and that's it. Then what you need to do is like from XGBB import BLP, right? And then very easy. What you need to do is blp.bdp or bdh or bds, whatever, like it all depends on the type of formula that you need to write. I just wrote NVIDIA US equity. We can write MSFT. Now, if you're a Bloomberg user, you know what is this. This is basically the ticker of Microsoft. MSFT US equity. For Apple, it is AAPL US equity. If you don't know what are the tickers, you can just write Microsoft here, and it will come here by clicking here. MSFT US equity is the ticker of Microsoft. You can just write DES to see the description. This is the basic Bloomberg usage. I am quite sure that you know this. So what you need to do here is write the ticker and the fields, FLDS, like on Bloomberg you just write FLDS and then write the different types of field. For example, security name is this one. So this is the mnemonic that we need. So I have written two things, and if I just do control enter, then come up with the security name, this one. You can also increase it if you want, PX last for example, and you'll see the last price of Microsoft for this one. It's very easy to use. You can also use BDH formula for the time series. I've used this thing actually a lot of times in order to do some data analytics, because for real-time data, basically, if you extract data in Excel using this functions, for example, then you cannot make an Excel file real-time and then at the same time synchronize it with, I would say, import it to the Python. It is sometimes very difficult to do it. That's why the best thing to do here is directly synchronizing it here and just refresh it again, and then the new data will be there. I think that is it for this video. I don't want to make a big video. Again, thank you so much for your support. I have crossed 200 subscribers. I just want it to be more than 500 very soon, and I'm pretty sure that I will reach this milestone very soon. And also, in order to support my share all my codes through the Google Drive access, and I hope you are enjoying all my codes. I can see that I'm receiving a lot of personal messages. I'm so sorry if I'm not able to answer all of them, but if you want to ask any question, there's a section here. Let me just click here again. There's a section in the last of that. If you have any questions right here, if you write any questions here, I'll definitely go through it. So that's it in this video. Much for your support.